Hi guys, Kyle here. Let's go do some day drinking. Today on Beer Time, I'm looking for a refreshment. That's what I want today, and this thing looks pretty refreshing. Let's see if it is. This is from the Traveler Beer Company. It's got a bunch of different beer companies listed on the sides. This is a collaboration beer with the Boston Beer Company. As far as I can tell, it's an outfit out of Vermont, neither here nor there. The graphics are pretty cool on this. And what we're looking to try today is the Elusive Traveler Grapefruit Ale. And it's got it's ale brewed with lemon peel, and it's got some grapefruit kind of added into it. So we'll see how this goes. The package really caught my eye. It's a beautiful shade of red and orange, and it's got a little mustache guy on the front of it with a little citrus monocle, and he's being like super bully, right? He's like, bully, and I like that. That's awesome. So let's give this a try. It's cloudy. Oh, and it just smells like piles of grapefruit. Super refreshing smelling. If you've ever had and I'm sure you have, a Blue Moon or something like that, it's a little bit like that. It's kind of an unfiltered wit beer taste, to be honest. But that doesn't hurt that here. I mean, if I go into this thing saying, I'm looking for a refreshing beer, this really is. It's got a very light effervescence to it. Almost looks like champagne bubbles a little bit. It's sweet, but that's balanced a little bit with just a little bit of tartness, so it's not cloyingly sweet, and that can be great. It doesn't have a huge aftertaste. The aftertaste is kind of like a little bit fruity, almost like, what am I thinking of? Kind of like the fruit gum, you know, the stuff in the yellow package, and you eat it, Juicy Fruit, and then the flavor's gone. That's exactly what this is. Ooh. But the nose on this thing is like, you know, super grapefruit, sweet grapefruit. And it's yummy beer. This is definitely be a session beer. It's 4.4%. You know, something like this, if somebody doesn't like, you know, fruity type beers, maybe this isn't the thing. I like to think the little bit of tartness in here kind of makes it special. And it gives it a little bit of complexity, because I feel like you're getting some interesting fruit notes in here and some, you know, more traditional beer flavors. And like I said, it's more like a Belgian wit beer, Americanized, if you will. And it's good. So, do I approve? I really like this morning. This is definitely an easy day drinking beer. Can you drink this in the morning? Absolutely. It's like just orange juice, man. You know, it's just getting your day started. This could stand in for a mimosa, like super easy. Say, I'm not a mimosa guy, you know, but I'm a beer guy. This is your mimosa right here. This is going to get it done for you. And then I think this would go great with, you know, summer stuff, particularly I think spicy Asian food or, you know, something south of the border would be great with this as well. And like I said, I really like the packaging on it. It's got a really easy date system on the side, which I really appreciate. That's super thoughtful. It's very nice. And again, the graphics are super fresh. I'll get a photograph on at the end of this. You know, this is a great way to start your day. Very nice if you can get out there and do that. I would suggest that you get out, have a coldie today, enjoy yourself, and do some day drinking. I'm going to get after this. Again, I like this. I would definitely buy it again and might throw a six in my cooler this week. So we'll check you on the flip side. And I hope you guys have a great day.